Good to go?
Good to go.
All right. We're back again, guys. We are live, CaseCast, episode number 6 here at the Cards Fund. I'm really excited for this episode.
It's a big one.
It is.
Some product here.
I do. So we're going to get right into it. We're not going to waste any time.
No.
If anyone happens to join the chat, we'll engage. But let's see what we have tonight. So first what we have, Jordan, if you could show this view real quick to the people. We have two packs here, two cello packs from Target of 2020 Prizm Football. Not easy to score these things. We have a story to tell you about how these were acquired.
Great story.
Then, of course, staple of the podcast, 2020 certified football. Wouldn't be a TCF cast, case cast, without certified. Then, my favorite product of the break that I'm most excited for. We have 2003 NetPro tennis cards. This is the premium edition box, which is really just the base set of NetPro. We are going to be looking for Rafael Nadal rookies, Serena Williams rookies, and Roger Federer rookies.
NetPro sounds like an early internet company.
It kind of does, like 1994,
yeah,
circa 94. Very excited. We'll open at least one of these, maybe both. We'll see what we get to, but I'm pumped for that. And of course, what is also becoming a staple, Pokemon Vivid Voltage. We got a full 36 pack booster box, and we're chonk hunting.
We're still chonk hunting.
So
we've yet to get him.
I'm feeling good about tonight, though.
And so John, shout out John, also yet to get him.
He's been ripping, though.
He has.
All right, everyone we know, ripping Vivid Voltage. No, we can't strike. No local luck on the rainbow rare fat Pikachu. But maybe tonight's the night.
Could be.
We'll see. All right. Let's get into the 2020 Prizm football. This was a disaster for me to acquire.
I need to hear the full story here while you're opening. Also, right. Whose pack is this?
This is mine.
Okay.
That'll be yours. All right. Good enough?
That works.
All right, so we'll start with myself. So, we got the red, white, and blue pack, so we'll start with this. You can come right to the cards, Jordan, because these are small. So, I got it to Target, okay? Jim McMahon. I actually met Jim McMahon. That's another story for another day. Nick Bosa and AJ Terrell, rookie. I went to Target, okay? I show up, and to my surprise, the stock guy was there.
Okay. What's he look like? I need a visual.
It's tough. He wears this mask that covers his whole face, so Okay. It's really hard to tell what he
like
actually
he's
looks like.
Like the joint?
Right, exactly. Okay. So he's stocking, and I noticed quickly that I am not the only person that has realized the sports cards are being put on the shelf. Everyone knows that Prizm is hitting the retail shelves. Got a Ben DiNucci rookie, green, has already made his appearance for the Cowboys. Fireworks Darius Leonard and a James Proch rookie. And so I'm standing there, you know, waiting for him to finish stocking, and he looks at me and he goes, "What are you looking for?" And I said, "Well, I'm looking for Prizm football." The guy goes, "You know what? I got two more packs left." I go, "Oh, wow, fantastic." He reaches into his box, mm-hmm. which appears to have a lot more than two packs in it.
Yeah.
Takes them, throws them at me. He goes, "Now leave me alone. I'd like to safely go home to my family tonight." Now I'm not within 6 feet of him. I'm quite far away. Like, he had to toss them to me across the aisle.
Both at once?
Both at once. So they hit the floor. So I can't guarantee you the
corners
aren't dinged.
Shout out Target.
So he throws him at me. He says, "Now get out of here. I want to go safely home to my family." I'm like, "Okay." So I get lost, but I have a feeling that he's still got a lot more, because there's no way that I just happen to get the last two. He hasn't even put them on the shelf yet.
Mm-hmm.
So I walk away. I run into nearly a dozen people who are waiting for him to leave the stock area. We all start chatting. We all start talking mm-hmm. about, you know, how we're going to be able to get this Prizm, what we're going to do. There's a nice KJ Hamler, red, white, and blue for you. And the guy, turns out he was just trolling us, because he was at this Target stocking for 2 hours. He would put two packs out, then he would walk away.
Would he put them out or throw them?
No, no one else approached him like I did, so they would go onto the shelf, whether mm-hmm. it was two cellos like this, there's mm-hmm. a Brady, or it could have been, and CJ Henderson is your rookie, so nothing great for us in Prizm, but that's okay. So he'd put, whether it be hanger boxes or two cellos, what up, JC? Welcome to the chat. And he would walk to the back into the stock room and just disappear. And the rest of us were like, what is this guy doing? Like, he clearly was upset that there were people stalking him, basically. Mm-hmm. And he clearly doesn't, you know, just the comment he made and the fact that he threw stuff at me.
So he gave you the cards first and then he played these games?
Right, right. So I happened to get the two, I think, because maybe I was, maybe no one else walked up to him. I'm not even really sure. And 10 minutes later, he'd reemerge from the stock room with a shopping cart, and he'd have that same big box of cards, mm-hmm. and he'd go back to the shelf, and he'd put two more out, and then he'd put a bunch of Pokemon cards out, and then he'd disappear back to the stock room. And everyone's like, this guy is just slow rolling us.
Yeah.
So moral of the story is there's plenty of Prizm. He lied to me that I got the last two packs because more than two appeared on the shelves.
Because he kept putting it out.
Right. He just didn't want us around. So clearly he's been hounded, harassed, possibly.
Well, it sounds like people are threatening his family.
Well, that's what that comment. I mean, I didn't know if that was like a COVID comment. Like right. he didn't want people near him for that purpose, which I totally understand. But that's just to be in this situation where cards have brought us to harass shelf stalkers. And the fact that 12 other people were there, I just happened to walk in when he was there. These people knew that he was going to be there. So,
did they all wait it out? Did they all get their packs?
I think when they realized he was playing games, most people left except mm-hmm. for me and one other guy. And we waited it out, and we got nothing.
Was
got
that an, Buffalo guy? For it.
That was the guy I was telling you about from Buffalo, yes. Guy. Drove all the way to Rochester, over 60 miles to canvas Targets and Walmarts looking for 2020 Prizm. And he was not successful. I, luckily.
So you got to respect the hustle.
Was successful. So while we're still talking, I'm going to rip a NetPro box here.
Bust this open.
Getting excited.
So did you get anything besides Prizm?
I did. I was able to get a couple Elite Trainer boxes of Champion's Path, which was very exciting. You know I'm super into the Pokemon game these days.
Yes, you are.
As are you. And that was nice because I don't think I've seen an Elite Trainer box on the retail shelves until today. So that was really cool to be able to get that. So I'm going to keep this box in good condition so I can store my cards in it.
They really packed them in there. There's no styrofoam or cardboard or anything. It's just all product.
No, it's 18 packs of pure 15 love, if you will. It's a weird attempt at a joke, but we'll go break style with this. And the guy that was from Buffalo actually told me a story about, because he clearly was like a hardo. Like right. He drove that far for hours looking for cards. So he told me the craziest thing he ever saw in retail was that a woman saw the guy stocking the shelves.
Mm-hmm.
Took every single box. This was last year during NBA Prizm release.
Yeah.
Took every NBA product in a shopping cart. Now, at the time, you were only supposed to get two products per customer.
Sure.
She walked, instead of trying to check out, she walked to the luggage aisle, grabbed a suitcase off the shelf, put like 40 boxes of Prizm into the suitcase, put the suitcase back on the shelf, and then walked with two boxes to the front of the store. So her plan was to come back every day, find the boxes that she stashed in the suitcase.
She's like packing them away for hibernation or something.
So she was just going to return every day to get two at a time, and meanwhile no one else would know where they were because they're in the suitcase.
What if someone just buys the suitcase and just gets a ton of Prizm?
Well, what ended up happening was that guy that I met, he just took them all. Because he saw her do it, and he just bought them all.
But there's a two-box limit.
He got away with it. The employee, so it's the stock person that cares, not necessarily the retail employees.
I thought where you were going with this was she was going to put it in the suitcase and just buy the
wheel
suitcase.
It. Yeah, right, exactly. Because it would have been way cheaper to do that. She should have done that. I mean, I'm not condoning this behavior. It's terrible what people are doing. But think of that, like being that obsessed and like need to have cards that you go through that much trouble.
She stores it in a suitcase.
Kind of clever, honestly.
It is. It's a good move. Because no one sees you, it's a good move.
Right, but Buffalo Boy. Just happened to get you right.
So you sent me a picture today, some more retail debauchery.
Yes.
Jordan, if you could pull that up real quick. You texted me this picture.
Right. So after I concluded my 2 hours.
It's on the Facebook.
My 2 hour stakeout of that vendor. Mm-hmm. I went over to Walmart to see this. Now what you're seeing here is two hanger boxes of Topps Update and a couple of pin collection boxes of Vivid Voltage and I think Sword and Shield. So people are just ripping these things open while they're on the shelves, taking the cards and so just going home.
They're just straight up stealing them.
This is theft.
And they're just leaving the ripped boxes there.
Right. Not even destroying the evidence. We got an interesting, no one can see that, but we got an interesting little thing on this pack. I don't know, this feels weird. Maybe we got some kind of relic or something. Tennis ball relic. I've seen that before, but I've never thought to discuss it on the pod.
I've seen that before too.
What are people doing? Who has the balls to rip packs in the aisle like this?
And then just take them and go.
I know. This is...
They must not get caught.
Well, how would you catch them? Because there's no you're not going to set the alarm off. Because you just have cards. They'd have to catch you on camera.
Yeah, on camera, you're just tearing into boxes.
Right. I guess they're really not monitoring this that closely. So, I don't know. I just don't like seeing this. There's just such little integrity left in the hobby. And honestly, people are desperate if they're doing this with 2020 update.
Right.
Like, what are you hoping to find in there that, like...
I mean... That should be what update costs, free.
Right, that's true. All. They should pay you to take it. I don't know. I didn't like seeing this, and I figured we could highlight, what to look out for. I didn't want to be that guy, but I almost wanted to, go to the manager and be like, mm-hmm. you need to, take a look at your inventory here, because this is not the first time I've seen this.
You need to check your suitcases.
Right. Please go to the luggage aisle and see if you've got any...
Could see how imagine? Much Prizm is in there?
Could you imagine just 2016 Prizm is in the luggage section? I could, oh man, if only. So I thought that was all pretty funny.
Well, at least you got a good story in addition to your two Prizm packs.
Right, very true, very true. Worth it though, I will say. Worth it to stick around, and I will be going back out tomorrow to look for more, because the same guy normally... I've seen him stocking other targets, and mm-hmm. he was only at the one today. So I'm going to go tomorrow, see if I can catch him again. Hopefully not engage.
You got this guy on lock.
Right.
He had a tracker device on him.
I basically do. All right. Here we go with the tennis cards. So
who are we looking for again here?
We're looking for Serena Williams.
Mm-hmm.
We're looking for... The Federer and the Nadal. Okay, so the Nadal in PSA 10 out of this set last sold for $700, and they're not that uncommon. If we open both boxes, which I don't know if we will, but if mm-hmm. we do, we're very likely to get one. And there's two Federers in the set, and those are selling. I think I saw one go for up as high as $480 in a PSA 10.
Those are rookies, the Federers?
They're considered rookies because this was the first tennis product since he debuted. Now, I don't know if this was actually any of their rookie seasons. So
take a look at these guys. Yeah.
So these are very weird feeling. My first time opening these. They're not the worst. Not the worst looking cards. I think they're kind of cool. If you look on the back for me, if you can look for cards numbered 91 or higher, those are short prints. Here's a Richard Gasquet. Nice Andre Agassi, Hall of Famer. Come on, we need Fed and Nadal.
So does it say RC or rookie or anything on there? Is it just...
I don't think there's a logo. There's a Venus.
Not her rookie.
Well, It might be, but it's I don't see these selling very well.
Okay, like just the Serena.
Right. I guess I have to, because they debuted around the same time, so it probably is her first card. I know Leaf had some tennis cards out there, which somebody actually sent me in the mail today, which I was not expecting.
Someone sent you Leaf tennis?
Yes. I ordered a lot of Serenas, 60 Serena cards, which if we pull one, I'll show you.
What's the short print number?
91 or higher. What do we got? Richard Gasquet. So, okay. So I guess I think the service poses are short prints. So I'll put that in here. Now, I think these are super undervalued and just a totally untapped market. You don't hear anybody really talking about tennis cards.
No one's in a tennis game.
And if these guys and gals are truly the greatest of all time, which they pretty much are, those three that we talked about, I mean, best clay player of all time, Federer maybe the best player of all time, Serena definitely the best female player of all time. Oh, and we got Rafa.
There he is.
That's huge.
What a beauty.
How does it look? I think I'm looking
inspect
right now.
That thing.
Rafael Nadal Pereira from Spain. All right, so on the top, there's a little bit of chipping. Just a slight bit. Not bad. Not bad.
The corners seem pretty sharp on these.
Corners are very sharp. Back looks solid. No chipping on the back with all the black bordering, so that's big.
It's nice, too. These don't stick together like the stadium club we had.
Right. They're not bricking. There's no bricking. So let's see if I can get... There you go. You can see that just the slightest chipping... That right there.
Yeah.
Ah, man, I don't know. I'm still going to send it in.
As you should.
I still got to send it. So I don't know. I think that's, if this is the first time you've ever seen this card, it won't be the last, because people are going to be buying, people are going to be branching out past football, past basketball, past baseball and hockey and even soccer. Tennis is the next one. Thank you for that. So these are $700 right now in a 10. When they become $7,000, you can thank me. Oh, and I have destroyed the top loader. Wow. Live on air.
Just crushing.
Sorry
loader.
About that. Live on our
That'll
air.
Be 5 cents.
Yeah, I got you, bro. All right. Sorry about that.
All good.
Very cool. All right.
Nice hit.
Let's continue to go.
Are these good to be looked through?
Yes. Look for the short prints. I think there might be one more. So I may grade like all the Hall of Famers and see what I can get for them, because here's another Venus, because there's just not that many out there. I know that at the time, Anna Kournikova was the card that everyone wanted out of these. James Blake. Look at James Blake when he had hair. Oh, and we got the Fed.
Look at that.
So there's two Feds in this set. This is obviously one of them. I don't think there's really much of a difference. This is, okay, so the other one is card number, is it one? This one's a higher number, I'm pretty sure. Nope, this is, okay, 11. I'm way off. No, Venus is one. Federer is double ones. And the other one maybe is the high number. So, okay.
Very nice.
This looks got really good.
At least two of them.
Not a lot, no chipping there. Pretty much nothing to discuss about centering because there's no border.
Right. Well, maybe the back.
I guess.
Tell,
I mean, I don't think that's like, I think they're all offset.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're all offset. So this looks good.
Very nice.
I think this has a great chance. So that'll be shipped off to PSA. We're going to be talking a little bit about PSA later.
And what do those go for? 10?
In a 10?
Mm-hmm.
I saw one as high as 480. Now, nice. I don't know why. Maybe because there's two Federers, so they don't go as high as the Nadal. I'm not sure. But the populations on the 10s are super low.
Like under 100?
They're under 200. Under they 200. Might be right around 100, between 100 and 200. Well, so we'll add
great
that.
Hits there for you.
Yep. Hoping to get at least, not at least, but maybe one more. Hoping to get the Serena, of course. Oh, and we got the other Fed right away.
Look at that.
Oh, man. This
loaded
is,
box.
This is exactly what I was hoping for. So, okay. Now, I said that was 1. So, that was 11. I'm going to say this is like super high number. Let's see. 67, I'm going to call it. 90. All right. Super high number, though. It is. It's the last card.
The highest one you can get without being a short print.
Last card in the set that's not a short print. Right. Okay.
He's done it. Both Feds and a Nadal.
There we go. 90. Yeah, this is big. All right. Let's inspect. maybe. Nope, that's just a little piece of dust, so that's good. Ah, bottom right corner might have
a little dingage.
It does. All right, so that one will not be going in. But still happy to pull the card. I actually have another one of these that came in the mail today.
What are your guesses on the grades for the other two?
I'm going to say 10 on the other Federer, and I'm probably 9 on the Nadal, but I'm going to hope for a 10. This one, definitely no chance, so I'm not going to waste my time. Could I have a sleeve, please, or a top loader? Thank you. Now, there's also... tennis cards go deep, okay? There's
I had no idea.
I got to pull up the list, because there's like 5 NetPro sets from 2003, and they all have different cards in them. So what we have here is the Premier Edition, okay? So this is like the base set. Comes in this box, obviously. Then there is the NetPro Elite set.
Okay.
Oh, there's the Serena. Man, we're just doing great. I'll get to that in a minute. Here's Serena. Little whitening on the top corner, so probably
no
10 on that.
You got everything you're looking for.
I did. A little whitening on that corner, so no 10 there, but this is a perfect box. Number 1, Serena Williams. Can I have a loader, please? Mm-hmm.
There's the one you were looking for.
Right. I don't know why I totally messed all that up, but that's okay. So the NetPro Elite, the cards that come out of there sell for a lot more. And
here's that one too.
Oh, thank you. I gotta look up real quick the numbering on those boxes. So the NetPro Elite, there's only 2,000 boxes made. So each box is numbered out of 2,000.
Okay.
They're all... here's the Williams sisters card. Cool. They're all images, at least of the big guys, Federer, Nadal, Serena. They're overhead images, so mm-hmm. like serving images.
Mm-hmm.
And those intens sell for a lot more, I think, because they come out of boxes that there were only 2,000 of. Then you've got the NetPro Glossy box.
Much like back in the day.
Right, like Fleer Glossy, yep, and Topps Tiffany, mm-hmm, that kind of thing.
I'll look through those.
Thank you. So I got to remember. So Glossy's out of 5,000.
Okay.
So more than the
Elite.
Than the Elite, thank you. But the Glossy has the same images as this NetPro Premier
Very
Edition.
Similar to like 80s Tiffany or
exactly
whatever.
So it's like a Topps versus Topps Tiffany. You have the premium versus the Glossy, and the Glossy 10s are like in four figures of those of the big names. So those are the more desirable ones, but you know, this is all I could afford at this point, because those Glossy boxes, not only are they impossible to find, but the sold listings of those were, I mean, hundreds of dollars, if not close to $1,000 for a box. Then you've got the International Series.
Jeez.
Which is a whole extra NetPro series, also from 2003, and I think the only difference I could tell was that they had like the flags of the countries on them,
mm-hmm,
and different images. So I guess NetPro had the monopoly over the tennis cards at that point, and they just decided in 1 year to release all these different sets. And so this is what we got. I chose the base set. These boxes were $85.
Okay.
And I thought that was a great deal.
It is, absolutely.
You know, if you think of a product that has three of the best of all time in it, and you see they're not hard to pull. We got every single one.
Got all of them.
I would expect a box like this, if this was baseball, if this was basketball, think of basketball, think of 86 Fleer, maybe the best set of all time. I mean, a box of that, I don't know what they go for, but
ridiculous.
$1 million? Like, I don't know, six figures for sure. This is $85.
It's a good find.
Right. So I think I got a bunch of these. I'm going to hold on to a bunch of them. I think we're going to hold off on the other one.
Sure.
For right
now.
You
got what you need here.
Yeah, it's true. So we'll leave that sealed and we'll head into Pokemon. But
okay.
I'm excited. And real quick, too, there's this jumbo card on the back. So we got Leighton Hewitt on this one.
Are you supposed to cut that out?
I think you might be, because let's look at the other one's actually Leighton Hewitt as well. So same. There's one of three different cards you can get. Here it says each bottom features Roddick, Hewitt, or Kournikova. I guess those are them on the front. So I don't know. That's like people are selling. I saw people selling just this. Mm-hmm. I guess it really is just the bottom of the box. Like,
interesting.
I don't know. I just think it's a super cool product, and it's not like, you know, oh, Benny's box breaks asked, did you break that 6 box of update? We did, Benny, yes. The update break started at 7, and we have completed it. You can watch the break back on the channel. The live stream is up there, mm-hmm. I assume.
Yeah, it should be.
All right. If you have any questions further, let us know. But yeah, like I said, there's no Fleer, there's no Upper Deck, there's no Bowman, there's no competition. Mm-hmm. This is the tops of the set. So
NetPro.
I'm going to be looking deeper into this, maybe trying to even acquire more, and I'm going to leave that one sealed.
Cornering the NetPro market.
Yes. And if anyone's interested in a box, you can let me know. Can I have the cards from this, please?
Sure can.
Just toss them in. If you want to start breaking that open while I'm doing this. Oh.
Giving me the big gig over here, huh?
No, can you handle it?
I can't even get through the plastic.
Tennis cards.
Look at you. We cover all sports and things over here.
I'm just going to go on a deep dive sometime and see.
Cricket? Do they have cards?
Ooh, that's
a big sport.
That's true, and it has a long history. That? Yes, I can. Let me give you your Prizm real quick while we get settled. That's you. What am I garbaging this?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right, so we're moving now into Vivid Voltage. We are looking for... Well, we can both break them open.
Yeah,
maybe.
Take That'd a be, stack.
We should do that from now on. I think that's a much better way to go about this. So we don't spend all episode ripping. Because you know I can't rip a pack to save my life.
You have your troubles. I'll admit it.
That was very... The way you said that, very gracious. Very couching. Thank you for the couching language.
You're welcome.
All right, so I mentioned that we were going to be discussing PSA.
Yes.
We've got to talk because it's the biggest news in the hobby right now. Maybe the most influential breaking news, far exceeding the Rob Kardashian TMZ news.
Yes. Jordan, can you pull up the second tab on that internet browser, please? Thank you very much.
So PSA... whose parent company is CLCT, Collectors Universe, has been acquired. And
they've been acquired.
They will be going from public to private. They were acquired by a investor group led by Nat Turner, who, if you don't know, you probably do if you're into cards, but if you don't know, Xavier Coleman, what happened?
Oh, we're talking about PSA. I think that's what he's
talking about. Oh, yes. I'm sorry. I'm discussing right now.
I think, if I had to guess.
Thank you for joining, by the way, guys. We're happy to have you guys here. So they're going private. Was that what I was saying? Yeah, they're going private.
By Nat Turner.
Right, acquired by Nat Turner. And I just learned this today that one of the other major players is Steve Cohen. Did you know that?
Really?
Yeah. So
really? Buying PSA?
PSA and the Mets.
Wow.
In the same
Let's
month.
Let's go Mets.
Within a couple weeks of each other.
Steve Cohen is my hero.
That's amazing, right? So this is truly just a New York kid's dream. To obviously, look, if you're from New York...
Nat Turner's a New Yorker now.
Oh, is he?
He lives there, at least.
Oh, I didn't know that either.
I could be very wrong, but...
I thought he was... I don't know. I don't want to get that wrong, but... Steve Cohen, if you grew up in New York, which he did, he just bought his childhood favorite team. And if you're from New York, Long Island area, you're also guaranteed to be a baseball card fan. He grew up in the 70s or 80s. It was the biggest thing on Long Island. It's still pretty big, actually, down there. The hobby is alive and well. And so just imagine being him right now. Just chilling with your billions.
Just buying everything in sight.
Right, your Mets, and now you have a huge stake in professional sports authenticators, collectors.
He
universe.
Also bought, this guy just has bottomless money.
Yeah.
He bought the Buckner World Series ball.
Really?
For like 400K.
Wow, that's quite the collector's item.
That's He's got really everything. Cool.
Maybe we should be focusing on him.
Yeah, I know.
Anything. We should do a whole cast on Cohen.
The Cohen cast. Yeah. Buy us out. We'll change the name. Give us $20. We'll change the name. You can afford
Steve,
it.
Steve, can you sling it? That would be great. So it was headed by, you know, the headlines are covering it as a Nat Turner acquisition because I think as a collector himself, that, you know, that's going to totally change the face of the company. And I think, at least my hope, is that being headed by maybe the biggest collector of all time.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I know you've seen his collection on Instagram and whatnot. That can only be a good thing, in my opinion. I think that he's going to be making it very collector friendly because he's one of us.
He doesn't have to please the shareholders now.
That's correct.
It's not all about profit.
Right. There's no board of directors. Mm-hmm. They don't have to meet quarterly earnings. You know, I'm not huge into, you know, multi-million-dollar acquisitions, but I assume that this will let them focus on their growing at their own speed, hiring the correct amount of personnel to handle the growth. Maybe lowering the turnaround times. Mm-hmm. I'm going to get started here on the Vivid Voltage. And I just think it's going to go really well. Zekrom Hollow. And I'm excited. A lot of people are saying it could go either way. Here, I'll give away the codes to anybody that wants.
Snipe those things.
You know, people are saying that it could just be more of a profit grab for him and his group, which sure they're gonna be in it to make money, but if you just look at the faces of who's there, it would really surprise me if they weren't really gonna make PSA like
it's people
10
who,
times better
who love what PSA is doing.
Right,
they're not just trying to strictly make money out of it.
Surfetched V, we've pulled this at least once, if not twice, probably the third time we have this now. I'm wondering when this is going to happen. I think, did they say Q1 of 2021?
Can you go back to that article real quick, Jordan?
Yeah, I'll pause on the breaking.
Can you just scroll down a little? I'm not sure if it'll say or not. Darren Rovell breaking this news.
Right, for Action Network. And yes, Xavier, he did buy PSA, and PSA is going private. That is true.
Is there any news on there about when it's happening? I'm not sure.
I don't know if I can't see it from here, but I think I thought it was 2020 first quarter 2021.
Okay,
so very soon. Yeah.
Thank you, Jordan.
All right, we'll go back now. Codes. What I mean, do you have thoughts? What do you think?
Well, basing it, I didn't know Steve Cohen was in on this.
Yeah.
And he has pretty much said he's going to be willing to drop as much money as he can on the Mets to make them good. I feel like he'll do the same thing with the card industry, whether it be grading machines or like an expedited process, something like that. I feel like he'll do whatever he wants, whatever he can to make things better.
I agree with you 100%. And Xavier, no, that does not mean you can't submit. You can still submit as per normal. I assume that there will be no lapse in the ability to submit. It just, the only thing that going private means is that it's, you can't trade it publicly on the New York Stock Exchange anymore under Collector's Universe. So it's not owned by shareholders. It's just a private company, but they still are absolutely going to be operating, and you definitely can continue to submit. Hopefully you can continue to submit at a cheaper price.
Right. Yeah. This could mean very good things for us. Back to the $8 bulk, the actual turnaround times that are listed on the site.
Right. And I don't think that they're going to severely reduce prices. Oh, here we got a nice Rayquaza Amazing Rare and a Colossal V back to back. So two nice pulls there. That's our second Colossal V. However, I'm sure they will make some change. I'm sure they will make some change to the price scale.
Yeah, I feel like they have to come in there and do something just to make it known that things aren't going to be as they were, where everyone's pissed every day about something new.
Right, exactly. And there is a lot of chatter about the digital side, the digital card grading technology. I think it's mostly just speculation still, I think, but I do think that I think people are right. I think that they're going to be looking into that and increasing their amount of I'm only 11, so I need money. Xavier, I wish you the best. If you're submitting to PSA as an 11-year-old, you're doing a great job.
Yeah, bravo.
Yeah, well done.
Steve Cohen, if you're watching, Xavier needs money.
He may be able to bring Xavier out of debt. We'll see. The digital grading will allow the uptick in volume for mm-hmm. sure. Like, they'll get more cards submitted, but they can also get more cards graded.
Right.
Now, if you're getting more cards submitted, maybe you can afford to lower the price because you're getting such a higher volume. You can afford it. Here's a Steelix
V. Simple economics.
Right, exactly. Xavier, if you don't mind, I got to ask, how did you find the channel? I'm happy to have you here. You might be our youngest audience member to date, if you are indeed 11.
It's amazing. I love it.
You're just surfing YouTube and you happen to run into us, or what? Dura Ludon, hollow there. Can't wait to. I'm just anticipating Xavier's reply. I don't know.
You want to look at the cards right now.
I know. Like, who cares about Tynamo when you've got 11-year-old X? Matang. All right. Well, anyway, it's all good. It's all good. I think people are going to always be on both sides. People are going to worry and say what they're going to say. I've heard way more positive sentiment around this than I have negative sentiment. We have another. Oh, we finally got at least a Pikachu hit. So we got a Pikachu V. It's not the Chonk, but that is a nice Pikachu V. That's not the full art, I don't think. I think that's just the regular ultra rare Pikachu.
A Kachu.
Cuckoo Kachu. What else we got? More codes for the people. I do TTM, so I saw you in that video in 2019. I tapped into your account, and I tapped on this, and that's all. Okay.
Oh,
the through the mail.
Yeah, the ones I got graded. Yeah. That's a classic. Thank you for watching.
Yeah, that's an old video. Yeah, I remember that one. Welcome. A Drapion V. So we got four Ultra Rares, but no Chonk.
We need a Chonk. The elusive Chonk.
Did you ever do TTM when you were younger? Through the mail, that don't know. I know your dad was into it.
Yep, I did. I didn't succeed much.
No?
The one I did hit was Dan Marino.
Really? That's a really cool auto.
He didn't send a card back, but he sent back like an 8x10 picture sign, so that was pretty cool.
Yeah.
And a letter.
So you sent him a card and he kept it?
Yeah. He sent back a signed picture.
Jeez. I hope it wasn't his rookie.
I don't know. I don't think it was. My dad would not have let me send a rookie card to him.
No, I wouldn't think so. He loves the Duke Snyder auto that you've got.
The old Duke. Yeah, I got to bring my dad's binder full of TTMs on here sometime. He has two, like, 3-inch binders just full of signed cards.
I think you were telling me that. That's unbelievable. X has Bob Cousy. What's your favorite TTM that you have, Xavier? Another ultra rare, man. Talonflame V. I think that's just the most predictable name. Fiery Talons. Talonflame.
This one's very horse racing. Mudsdale.
Okay, yeah. A muddy Clydesdale.
He's a mudder.
Come on, Chonk. One time. 4 days ago, RIP Duke.
Who is... I think Pat Neshek will sign anything you send to him.
Is that right?
Yeah, he sent out a tweet, like, if you want anything signed, here's the address. I'll sign anything.
Wow. I've never been involved in the through the mail game, ever. I didn't even know that was really a thing, to be honest. But apparently it's still alive and well. Do you know when they started issuing pack pullable autographs? There's a Zamazenta, amazing rare.
Do you know the answer?
I have no idea.
If I had to guess, the late 90s.
That's probably a fair guess. I think I'd probably say the same thing. Ron Guidry, Dave Parker, says Xavier.
Can you actually look that up, Jordan, while we're going through these? First autographed card. Or something like
that. Yeah, or maybe, yeah, I'll see if that works. Vita Blue. Blue Moon Odom, maybe.
You have a Barry Sanders?
Oh, wow. That's Barry awesome. Sanders, yeah.
Jeez, Xavier's had some success here.
Jeez.
He's got a Hall of Fame class.
Zygarde Hollow. Roger Craig and Goose Gossage. Very cool.
Do you have any Tom Gordon?
Do like sports first card. First pack pulled autograph. Try that. What else we got? Oh, Orr Beetle VMAX. Didn't we pull that last time, too?
Yeah, we did.
Jeez.
A lot of dupes. I do, at some point, want to get into this app or website called Dibs.
Yeah, let's talk about Dibs.
But let's let Jordan... Did you find anything about the... All right, we'll have to look that up another time. Maybe we'll follow up next episode.
Yeah, because I'm interested in figuring that out. I think you're right.
It's a good trivia question. And what sport do you think it was?
I would say it was probably baseball. I just think the baseball had the biggest cards, biggest card market.
So what was I saying?
You want to talk about Dibs?
Yes. So this
colossal VMAX.
Jeez, we got him last time too. We got two did. Colossals.
Jeez, what is Dibs? We're gonna tell you, Xavier.
As soon as we finish these Pokemon, we'll show you the website. But Dibs is basically a place... I don't think they're live yet. You have to put in your email to sign up to be on a waiting list, which I obviously had to do.
Okay.
But you can invest in fractional amounts of cards. So say you want to be in on a Mike Trout rookie, but you don't have $2,500 to drop, you can put in like $100 and own a fraction of that card.
I love that. I've heard of it through Rally Road as well.
Yep, very similar.
I think it's such a great concept, these micro shares.
Mm-hmm.
And does Rally Road do it with cars, sports cars as well? I think that's why it's called Rally Road.
I know they do. They do art, comic books.
Okay.
Cards, obviously. I bet they do cars.
I think that's where they got their name, if I'm not mistaken.
Dibs the ice cream. So pretty cool. So you don't have to drop a whole nut on a Mike Trout.
Right.
You can kind of diversify too if you want to.
Right.
I don't know. I think anything that can get you into the game is always good.
I agree. And this is really, I think people.
Jordan, can you pull up their website real quick?
Excuse me.
Thank you.
People know the most about the biggest stars, and
right.
People want to own the biggest stars, but the right. biggest stars are the hardest cards to own, of
exactly.
course, obviously. So this is perfect.
Yeah.
If you really believe someone's the greatest of all time that already has had an incredible career, like mm-hmm. if you want to invest in Trout, if you want to invest in Patrick Mahomes, right? If you want to invest in like a Connor McDavid, even, and
right.
I think I'm sure his Future Watch autos are hard to get, or his Young Guns cards,
right?
So if you want to get into these guys who are active even, and you want to watch them play and watch their stock, so to speak, grow,
mm-hmm.
you don't have to drop thousands of dollars to own this card. You can just buy a share, which I think is fantastic.
And it's sort of similar to like a Bitcoin. They're 24-hour trading on this website, if you scroll down a little. So they're sort of touting themselves as like the Bitcoin of the sports market world, the sports card world.
Oh, this is fantastic. And their interface is amazing.
And you can buy and sell. So player collections. So like, what would that be? Like almost like an ETF of a player. Or like a mutual fund. Yeah.
Yeah, that is. And I just love I'm being like sucked in by the colors and the
great,
graphics.
Great website design.
Yeah,
great graphics.
The optics here are second to none. I know I've said a lot of negative things on this podcast about a lot of things, but this is not one of them. This is
so sports card investors invested into this.
Oh yeah, look at that. So I know sports card investor. I don't know those other three.
Yeah,
but this is great. Now you said they're not live yet.
I don't believe they're live yet. So if you keep going down, I think you have to put in your email, and then they'll. So there's a wait list right now. So I joined the wait list.
Okay, I'll definitely do that.
You should do it.
Now, do you think? Oh man, I have so many questions. We could go all night on this.
That's great.
I'm gonna crack this while we're talking
sure.
about it.
So this was actually, I don't know if I already mentioned this, but Jonathan Bales, big in the DFS game.
Mm-hmm.
He has a weekly newsletter that he sends out, and this was one of the things he was touting in last week's.
He's one of the sharpest guys I have heard in the industry. So if he's on this, mm-hmm. I'm all about it.
He tried to, speaking of him, he tried to buy a T206 Wagner. Him and like Peter Jennings, Empire Maker, they tried to go in and get it, but they couldn't close.
Oh, that's unfortunately. Crazy. Do you know like the details of that? You know the price that they were negotiating?
No, it was an auction, I think. It was a gold, maybe golden auctions. Yeah. They were live till the very end, supposedly, and then they missed out, but
that's too bad.
Yeah, I'm glad he showed me this thing in his newsletter, because this could be big.
And I'm glad you showed me on this podcast.
And all three of you watching right now, if you guys want to sign up.
I think that's so cool. Now, do you think they're going to do it like IPO style, where they'll have a few cards available on a certain day and you can you buy?
That's a good question.
Or do you think like they'll release all their cards at once when they open?
So they have to, this company has to buy the physical cards, right?
They have I'm sure they have a vault somewhere.
Yeah, it's very interesting.
This is,
I'm not sure.
I gotta learn more about them. They probably I'm sure they keep them in a warehouse.
Right, so they're probably gonna go for the big name cards first, like the Trouts and the Jordans and that sort of thing.
Right.
But it would be cool if you could get in like on some smaller time guys.
Right, right. Even like a rookie silver from last year's class that's not Ja or Zion, like
right.
maybe it's $300-$400, and you just like they could sell dollar shares of that.
Yeah.
You know, and if anyone ever blows up.
Yep.
Such a cool concept.
It is.
And it just shows that there is a future here.
Mm-hmm. It's just, it keeps evolving too.
Right.
What did Xavier say?
Xavier says, don't invest in Randy or Rosarina, his career might end. You may be right, Xavier. I would worry too about what we just saw with Randy. We did talk about that, I think.
They
on our
tossed
last
out
guest.
His case.
Oh, they did?
Yeah,
I didn't hear
there
that.
There was not enough evidence.
Minka Fitzpatrick to 237.
Weird.
Have you ever seen a card numbered to 237?
That's like their game time today.
Very true. Steelers victorious, 11-0 now. Here's a Herbert 2020 insert. I'm sure you could sell that for a few bucks. Xavier loves football. Well, you're in luck, Xavier, because we've got a
we've
box
got
here.
Some.
George Kittle, number to 450. Come on. There we go. 450, George Kittle. Oh, I got to sleeve that up.
The mirror.
Xavier also loves Minka Fitzpatrick. Who's your favorite football player, Xavier?
And your favorite team.
Right. Guys, if you join the chat next time, if you're watching this on delay, you can ask all the same questions as Xavier. Unfettered access to our brains.
Also, may even do some sort of giveaway next week. So
that's true. So tune in. If you're live in the chat, I'm going to stop doing this. I just can't get it to work. Devin to 299. What are you thinking? You thinking cards? You thinking a box? What are you going to give the
man,
people?
Man, I almost picked up a box of update from Target today to give away, but couldn't pull the trig.
Ah.
Probably some graded card I have lying around, maybe.
Very nice.
We'll see.
Nick Bosa, fabric of the game. That's number two. $299. Look at me. Like I've done this before.
Did you nail the focus?
Absolutely.
Didn't you just say you weren't going to do that?
Yeah, anymore? I lied. I just straight up lied. Julio Gold.
You had to redeem yourself. I get it.
I did. All right. We're winding down. Do we got anything else we want to talk about?
It was
1990s. 90s for the first pack pulled autograph. All right. Thank you, producer Jordan.
Can you sleeve that, Herbert?
Of course.
Thank you.
Here's an Alan Lazard auto to 50. Mirror auto.
I need to know what Xavier's favorite player and team is.
I know. He just says, I want that. We don't know what he's talking about. He's crying. Xavier's crying. Don't cry. Xavier, don't cry. It's fine. It's just cards. Oh, man. The late viewer is going to have no idea what's happening. The fire in the chat right now. John Elway, the greatest. Chris Godwin.
Xavier, I'm sorry. Please stop. Please stop crying.
Seal of approval. Tyreek Hill to 75. This was quite the performance that he had in the first quarter last week. Over 200 yards and two touchdowns in one quarter of NFL action. That's a cool card. I like that.
Who's your RPA prediction for this?
Oh, that's true. We haven't pulled it yet. I think it's going to be this guy, actually. Keyshawn Vaughn.
Okay.
That is my prediction. He likes the Niners and Herbert so far. Fair enough. We got a Cleveland gold to 25. Nick Chubb. A healthy Chubb is producing for the Browns. Not bad. Does he dare focus it? He does.
He does. He strikes again.
I cut you off. What did you say? What were you going to say?
I don't know. I have no idea.
Something about our next topic.
No.
I wanted to. Oh, I know what I wanted to talk about real quick. Oh, he also Xavier also likes Clyde and Herfire. Clyde Elaire. Oh, Elaire. Got it. Clyde Edwards Elaire. I wanted to talk about LeBron James Wheaties box flippers.
Okay, let's hear it.
Here's Gilmore to 399. Have you seen this? I mean, this is.
Are these? When did these boxes come out recently?
I actually have no idea when they're from. I assume they're recent because I've seen them popping up recently.
Mm-hmm.
But people are selling cereal boxes on eBay. I don't know if they even have the cereal in them. They probably don't. But people are trying to make 100% profit on a...
What are they selling them for, like 50 bucks?
15 bucks. Oh. But it's like...
Why did I think cereal was $25?
Yeah, I don't know what cereal you're eating, but... That's some bougie cereal. $25 a box.
For Wheaties.
So yeah, they're like $15 a box just because it has LeBron on the front, and they're selling on eBay. This reminds me of the Flutie Flakes craze.
Oh yeah,
of the early 2000s. You remember the Flutie Flakes?
Of course I do.
Those were horrible. It was horrible cereal, but it was great to have Flutie on your mantle. Oh, we got a nice RPA that I didn't predict, but Jerry Jeudy to 225. That's the orange. Really cool. Nice patch. I do like these freshman fabric
They're
inserts.
Nice.
You sold some of the ones we've pulled?
I have.
That's okay, Xavier. Don't worry about it. You're only 11.
Just sold the Hurts we had last week.
Oh, Jalen. Yeah, what'd that go for?
It was like 60 bucks.
It's not bad for a certified RPA. I can dig it. You've got a good collection of them now. You've got what, 10 of them? 12 of them? I mean,
12
is that how many
them.
Were in this case?
12.
That's
we're out of certified.
I know the staple product is finally.
We gotta
to
find
an end.
Something else.
I'm thinking we look into what's the one that just came out today? It was Rookies and Stars. You heard of Rookies and Stars?
What is Xavier saying here?
Xavier, oh, he probably loves the Jeudy. I think he really likes the Jeudy in the chat that we pulled. So
nice.
It was a nice Jeudy, Xavier. I agree. Jude, yeah. He was good. Panini Rookies and Stars came out maybe today or this week. They were stocking that at Target. I probably
okay,
should have picked
that,
some of that
football?
Up. Yep. I didn't think to pick it up, but it comes in hanger boxes, mega boxes, hanger cello packs like mm-hmm. the ones we opened. So maybe you can get a case of that. I can't. It's a lower end product
yeah.
and it still has all the guys that we're looking for.
I was looking. I got a trivia for you.
Hit me. I
How
love
much
trivia.
Would you say a 2018 Prizm basketball hobby box goes for?
2018 Prizm hobby.
That's the Luca.
That's Luca Trey?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
A single hobby box.
A single hobby box. I'm going to say it goes for $2,800.
Not even close.
Is it like $10,000?
It's over $7,000.
Oh, my God. That is egregious.
For a hobby box.
So how many were in a case? Do you remember? Was it 10, 12, 8?
Something like that. Regardless.
I mean, you're looking at 60K,
Xavier
70K.
Xavier says 300.
300 per card, maybe. But yeah,
that was like when they first came out. They were like 300.
They were like, yeah, more even. The MSRP on those, like the pre-order price, is like 150.
Yeah,
That's $7,000 for a product that's 2 years old.
I'm sorry, Xavier.
Don't worry about it, Xavier. No problem.
Yeah. So even if you get a Luka base, you're not getting your money back.
How much?
What's a Luka silver actually these days?
Silvers, I don't know. I mean, the base tens are like 1,700.
Right.
So you'd need a silver or something, or a tray silver
to get your money back.
Right. That's an ridiculous. Egregious price.
Yeah.
Because there's plenty of other rookies in the class, but those are the two driving the product. I mean,
I think just, Shea is in there.
Shea's in there. But still, and Jaren Jackson, you know, he sells okay. And
but still, you have to hit all of them to just make your money back.
$7,000.
No NetPro. Tell you that much.
No, but they're treating it. See, that's the problem. Is like, that's why I buy things like this, because people are treating 2018 Prizm like it's 1986 Fleer.
Right.
Like,
and they're treating it like you're guaranteed to get one of each rookie.
Right. You got no idea what's in there.
Right. You could get none of them.
Right. Huge checklist.
You could get $50 worth of cards out of that.
Right. And parallels like galore, right? Mm-hmm. You don't know. You're going to get reds and a gold, but it could be a vet. It could be nobody that you care about. No, usually not. It's one box. I'm thinking if you get a case, but no, it's one box.
Yeah.
You're going to get like two silvers, four silvers at most. My friend's friend is related to Trey, Xavier
no
says.
Way.
That's awesome. You got to get us some you got to get some TTM Trey.
Yeah, you should. Should be your main target.
I was going to say something about Prizm. I don't know. I do remember. So like I was saying, Luka, while we're talking about 2018, Luka was or is around 1,700. I saw a conversation on Twitter. I'm not going to like name drop and embarrass anybody. Not that they're going to see this, but
they might.
It's a very well-known person on Twitter, not in the sports card community, but it's the DFS community. He's saying that he believes that the $1,700 Luka base 10 in just 3 years could be worth $10,000. Now, If Luka wins MVP for the next 3 years and wins the finals the next 3 years, the card won't be $10,000. First of all,
there's so many.
They're right. They're the pop report on that. There's like 20,000 in the pop. I don't know how many tens. He won't let me meet him. Oh, that's sad, Xavier. You got to keep trying. Try to get Trey.
Don't give up.
PSA 10s, I don't know how many there are, but there's over 20,000 of these cards available. Okay. Now you look at the 2003 Topps Chrome LeBron James.
I was just going to say LeBron.
There's not 20,000 of those. There's like 1,000 less.
Yeah.
And those are 11K.
Right.
And he's
guy's insane.
He's spent 18 years winning MVPs, winning finals, rings, showing up in the finals every year, it seems like, and basically becoming one of the best players of all time. And he's 11K for PSA 10 that there's a small fraction of. Luka would have to average 86 points a game for the next 3 years if he were to ever be anywhere close.
If you buy anything Luka right now, I feel like it's bad.
I do think it's bad because of it's like peaking right now, but the fact that there's a lot of influential people like this guy that are saying that is going to make people buy in at this price.
But it's going to come crashing down eventually. It has to, right?
I guess at some point it has to regulate when there's that much supply. But who knows where we're going to go with all this demand. I just don't think it'll be 10K. Not in 3 years. Give it 20 years if he really
maybe
is the
best
ever.
Maybe not ever. Base Prizm?
No, he would have to be Michael. He'd have to be Michael Jordan.
Yeah.
Like he would there's nothing else to it. With that many available copies, he'd have to average a career 40, 10 and 15. And win the finals every like it's just not gonna happen. So
he's a great player, but 10K and
but I like that I see that type of sentiment though, because it just is gonna bring more people in and get more people excited.
Right.
I don't care what level you're buying in at. If you want to buy Luka now, buy Luka now. He could go up.
Use dibs to buy Luka.
There you go. That's a great way to
sponsor
end.
Us.
Great
dibs.
Way to great way to promote dibs. All right. Is that it? I think we're good.
Yeah, does Xavier have anything to say in closing here?
Yeah, Xavier, if you have any other comments for us, let us know. Thank you to everybody that tuned in live, and thank you to everybody that is tuning in after the fact. We're going to try and do these live every week, so catch us, mostly Wednesdays.
Yeah, usually Wednesdays.
Wednesday nights around 9 o'clock-ish, depends on the night. It just depends what we're doing. If everyone wants to go check out thecardsfund.com, if you guys make an account on our website, you can buy into our case breaks that we do. We've got Bowman Draft 2020 coming up, hopefully next week. The cases came out today, so hopefully we'll have it in time for next week. We'll post, the prices for sale on the website. You can buy them there, and you can earn rewards points for every dollar that you spend. You can use towards break credit in the future. You can follow us on Instagram and on Twitter at Cards Fund. You can go on Facebook, search TCF Case Breaks, join our Facebook group so you know when we're breaking. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, leave a comment, click the like button, ring the notification bell, do all the good stuff for the algorithm. Help us out. We really appreciate it. And, Xavier has one last question. Can you do a big card opening on Christmas Eve? Xavier, oh, man. Christmas Eve's a tough night for us. I think I'll be traveling. I don't know what Ryan's going to be doing on Christmas Eve. But unfortunately.
Maybe Festivus.
Okay.
The 23rd.
The 23rd of December.
Maybe.
All right, we'll see. Unfortunately, Christmas Eve is out for us. But I appreciate that you're interested in us. Keep following us. Xavier, make sure you subscribe. And we can't wait to have you back. So with all that said, thanks for watching CaseCast number 6. We'll see you hopefully next week. Peace, Nuggets.